Hello there. This is an astrological forecast for Virgo for the year 2010. And this also applies if you have a Virgo ascendant. So Virgos, your theme this year is going to be your relationships, your work, your career, and your finances. Let me break this down into the various transits and how they're going to be affecting you. The first thing I'd like to draw your attention to is that Mars retrograde for the first 3 months of the year, approximately, is in your 12th house. So very important for you timid Virgos, many of you are timid, to actually get your anger out, your emotions out, and your passion out. Very important that you don't go inside yourselves, because many of you have had a really difficult time with this transit of Saturn in your sign. I know that. But with this Mars going retrograde, don't allow it to make you go introverted again and to keep your emotions in. It's really important that you either do physical exercise or movement or whatever it is to get your emotions out and your feelings out. Because if you don't do this, then all your passion is suppressed and held on the inside. This will lift around the middle of March anyway, when Mars will be moving forwards. It's still in your 12th house until around May time. After around May, Mars comes into your first house, and then you'll feel a sudden boost of energy moving forward. And as long as you've not held yourself back, then this will be really beneficial for you, and you'll really feel great at that point. So Saturn has finally moved out of this first house and is in your second house for most of the year. This means it's time to look at your values. Really now, Virgos, what's important to you? You need to reassess your values, not only on the material level, on things, but also on the mental, the emotional, the ethical, the spiritual level. What's important to you? And look at how you're going to move forward in relation to these new values, because I think you are going to, over this transit of Saturn, really reassess what's important to you. And it's changed a lot. I think things have changed a lot for you. It's a time to be very frugal with money. Not that you're particularly extravagant for the most part, but really be frugal, really be careful. Try to cut down your expenses. It's not a time to splash out, to take out debt, to buy lots of luxury things. No, it's quite the opposite. It's the time to really, to the best of your ability, downsize and make best use of any resources that you have. Very briefly, between April and July, Saturn does go back into Virgo, the very latter degrees of Virgo, and it's a final bugle call, actually, to say to you, hey, have you got your goals in order? Do you know what's important to you? Do you know really where you're going? And have you got rid of things that are not working to you in your life? Are you still holding on? And is there anything you need to get rid of? So that will be a final little call to you. And then you're off and you're upwards, and you need to be just clear that you are in alignment with your goals. Now, Pluto is in your fifth house all year. So for many of you, this can mean a love affair. This can mean a very deep emotional attachment and a very intense time with somebody. It's important with Pluto not to get obsessive. There's a tendency with Pluto where something can become obsessive for you. If it's something that's healthy, like something that's creative, that you're really focusing and putting your energy into, then that's a great thing. But if it becomes obsessive, where it becomes a negative thing, where it takes you off your focus in your life and you're just focused on this other person that's taking you off balance, then that's not nourishing, and you need to just watch out for that. If a relationship that you have is in trouble, it's not going to survive this transit of Pluto. It will be undone. But if you have a relationship during this transit and you actually sustain this relationship, then it's going to be everlasting. You will find that you have something that is really forever. It's a great time as well to look at the creativity that you have inside of you and to really dig deeper, because there's so much inside of you, Virgo, that needs to come out, that's not yet come out. And you need to maybe do some research and to take a bit of time out to really bring out these skills. Many of you are great healers. Many of you have wonderful healing abilities that are yet to be explored. And many of you are to bring together the mind and body and the emotions to bring together this whole medical field and to have more of an understanding in that. I really feel that for many of you Virgos. Neptune is in your sixth house all year, which means you need to take a look at your health. You need to see it clearly. You need to also look at your work area and to be maybe aware of the people around you. It's a very good time to get involved with very meaningful work and work which involves maybe caring for others, helping others in some kind of a way, some kind of charity, some kind of helpful work. Even if it's only a small amount of your time that gets devoted to that, that will be very, very nourishing for you and very satisfying for you, and also give you a lot of self-confidence, which many of you need. For most of the year, Jupiter and Uranus are in your seventh house of relationship. So expect an expansion in this area, Virgos. Expect more people to come into your life. Expect some interesting, exciting new people to be coming into your life. For those of you that are in a relationship where you're feeling restricted, you can bet your bottom dollar that you're going to feel as though you need to break out of this. So really, you either bring more excitement into this existing relationship and make it feel freer, or the relationship will definitely come to an end. However, if you can bring excitement into your existing relationship, then it will really thrive and it will grow. Jupiter-Uranus bring to you some interesting people, some exciting new connections, and so allow yourself to be a little more open to these new people coming into your life. Some of them are going to be very supportive and very helpful and very generous to you. I see a lot of generosity of spirit coming to you from other people, if only you will accept it. So allow this to come in, Virgos, because I think this is going to be quite exciting. If those of you are staying in a relationship for the sake of the children or because of a financial situation, well, that's probably going to get blown to pieces during this transit. So be aware that this is a time for freedom. It's a time for you to really enjoy your relationships and not to feel as though they are burdensome and difficult and heavy for you. I want that heaviness to lift. You've had so much heaviness. I want that to really lift and for you to feel the lightness and the newness that's just waiting to come on in. So there you have it. This year is going to be about your finances, about being careful, about looking at your values and what's important to you, about going very deeply into a relationship. There's a strong possibility of that. About taking care of your health and also allowing these new and exciting relationships to come in and bringing excitement into your existing relationships. So I wish you a wonderful year ahead. For those of you that would like to see these predictions in writing, I will have them up on my website, and you may like to consider having an in-depth reading for yourself. I wish you a great year, and I thank you very much for listening. Bye for now.